broadcast live.
All right, welcome to the show. This is part two of episode number two. I'm sure you guys saw part one and you guys probably had a lot of questions. You weren't sure about a couple of things. If that is the case, please don't be scared to hit us in the comment section. All questions you want to know, just ask them there and then we'll answer them in the following episode. So this is part two of episode two, still featuring my hook man, Fistaz Mixwell. I think a lot of the guys, they're always complaining and they're saying, you know how you spoke about having your things on the internet and on SoundCloud, but they speak about how music compilers and DJs and so forth don't answer emails, so they feel kind of stuck.
Yeah.
What advice would you give to the young guy out there who feels like he's been trying, he's really talented, but like he's not getting through to a Fistaz Mixwell, he's not getting through to a Speedsta, he's just not getting through, he doesn't know what to do?
You know what, me, if you feel like, you strongly feel like you're not winning, there's nothing that stops you from being, from pushing a little harder. For example, what stops you from tweeting the radio station in question? Hi, my name is so-and-so. I believe that I've got a hot song. Here's my clip. Why? When you put pressure on these big organizations and you expose them, half the time you get away with it because they can't ignore you. You know what I mean? I mean, you've seen on Twitter. You tag any brand for whatever reason.
Yeah, they respond.
Yeah. So I keep asking myself, people that are complaining about their songs not being played, why aren't you speaking to the station in public? Because you've tried to speak to them in private, right? You're not winning. Speak to them in public.
What if you don't have followers though? What if you don't have like the power? Like you maybe
Dude,
you don't
let
have
me tell
followers.
You, it doesn't matter. People, when you tag a station, people see it.
Yeah.
Because it's just the way the internet works, you know? So sometimes just because you don't have followers doesn't mean that a big brand or big station can't talk to you directly.
Yeah. So like a music compiler or like a music manager, when they get music at the station, their job is to go every day and listen to music the whole day.
No, you know what? I think this is where things have gone wrong in our industry. I mean, I'm not saying that we were doing things better, but I think in a way I'm saying that. Listen to this. Give me a second. Back then, being a music manager is like being an A&R at a record label. Your job is to find new music. Like music is not supposed to find you. It's supposed to be the other way around. So that's where we've sort of lost it. Oh. I used to go to concerts and just listen to people.
Oh, that's why it was always DJs.
Exactly, that's why it was always DJs. I mean, I remember Tear Gas. I literally went to, I heard a song of theirs somewhere and I went to a concert somewhere and they were performing. When they're done, I went to the side and I spoke to the guys. I'm like, hey guys, I really like your music. We think you're ready to sample it for radio. And they're like, yeah, why not? I mean, they were so excited. Literally, on Monday, they were in my office. Before the guys left the parking lot, they were listening to the song on radio.
Sure.
You see, that's the power of being out
and
there.
And also, I'm sure there wasn't systems.
Exactly.
Go to mang.
Exactly. Now, music compilers, I just feel like we're just sitting and we're waiting for music to find us.
I know. I know. Actually, MTV Bass has been doing that for the past 8 to 9 years.
Okay.
And you can see it with the ARs because the numbers have gone up like a lot. And it was all because VG was doing that. VG was doing the music. So if you watch, you see that there's a flow. So maybe the way forward is for music stations to go back to having DJs, people that are on the ground, to be the music compilers.
For sure. I mean, whether you like it or not, your job takes you everywhere. You know, you're performing at some concert there, tomorrow you're in Polokwane. It gives you sort of like a view of just what's happening nationally. You see, a person that doesn't travel, that doesn't do gigs, you're always confined to your homework. But when you're a DJ, your job puts you out there, you know? So it's very easy for you to find out what's happening in each and every guy's your city.
Sure.
So that's a very simple thing.
I never actually really thought about that.
Yeah.
Maybe radio stations must look into
that. That's very important, yeah.
So what happens if there is a DJ, a music compiler that is a DJ, but he doesn't have gigs? What happens then?
Well, I think maybe the station needs to get him to travel, you know? I remember when I was doing music, my station manager, you know, sometimes I'd get to work on a Friday, heaven. And they're like, no, put your bag in the office, we're going. And we'd get in a kumbi. And we would drive and listen to other stations. Like, we'd drive to, like, Durban, and then we'd sleep there, and then we'd drive back, listening to Orange Free State Radio, what. And we weren't just discovering new music that other stations were playing. We also discovering new talent. Like, I mean, you're driving through the Free State, you're listening to OEFM, and you're like, hey?
Yeah.
And right then, there you pick talent, you know?
Sure.
But that thing doesn't happen anymore. You know how it is. You need to have a million followers for you to get a radio show these days. Yeah, I did say that.
Who are some of the artists you mentioned, Tiggers? Who are some of the artists that you broke when you were still the music compiler at Metro?
My favorites was guys like Rhythmic Elements. You know that song, 2x2? Literally, you know, it's one of those you hear a song and you put it on air now. I mean, a good friend of mine, Monday, DJ Monday, he used to do the same job that I was doing.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace, bro. And then, you know those days, because we used to get sampled music the same day. Sometimes I'd call him, hey, did you get this track? What do you think? Like, ah, it's on fire. I go, okay. Hey, right, qual lor, right?
Yeah,
right. I reckon you get a show. Sharp. After the news, 3 o'clock, both stations. Yeah. And I tell you, we used to make songs, put them on blast, you know? And we used to enjoy what we were doing because we used to communicate.
Yeah.
Today's music compilers don't even bother talking to each other. Just because the radio stations are competing, doesn't mean that the people that are responsible for the music. Because sometimes you hear a song, right? And you're not sure about it. Like, hey, is it working? It's nothing wrong picking up the phone. You ask 5FM, whatever. Hey, man, what do you think of this song? I think it's on fire. Okay. So that makes sure that you're not making a mistake by putting that song on air now and going to town with it. So that's what we used to do. And I don't think that's happening anymore.
Well, there you have it, guys. maybe it should go back to DJs being the music compilers and it just being about the music.
Yeah.
It not being about how many followers you have and how you look, or you know what I mean? If it's dope, it's dope. I hope that was insightful. That was part two of episode two of Speedsta In Da Park. We're about to go play a game of skate. Come check it out. All right, guys, so it's the fun part of the show where it's time for me to play a game of skates with any skater that is out here. There are only two guys here, so I'm gonna let our guest for today decide which skater I will play a game of skate against.
I'm going to nominate the guy in the white shirt.
The guy in the white shirt. Yeah, all right, cool. That's cool. Dada. All right, cool.
Yeah,
there you have it. See. Dada and I are going to play a game of skate. And let's see how it goes. Sure. Are you ready? Kick your ass. All right, cool. Peace. Let's do it. That shit I like. That shit I like. Don't let him know. Alright guys, there you have it. That is the end of episode 2, part 2 featuring Fistaz Mixwell. Thank you very much for coming through.
You forgot to tell people to subscribe. I always watch YouTube videos.
This one is not makeup. Please comment rather. Don't subscribe. Just comment below if you have any more questions or whatever. And I will answer them in episode 3. Thank you very much for joining us. Speedsta In Da Park, Fistaz Mixwell. Go follow him. He's handles are here. Go check him out. Voila.
Broadcast live.